So let's see if we can work out which of the earthing arrangements we've got here in this installation. Kilowatt hour meter. We're fortunate to get a linked main switch or a double pole switch inserted in the tails, which allows us to isolate the supply without the need to remove the fuse here. Okay, so that's handy. So if I wanted to work in my distribution board, perhaps even replace it in this installation, I can turn it off from out here, prove the installation is dead, and then change it without the requirements to get the supply authority's permission in order to cut these metal seals here and here and remove the fuse itself. So we've got double insulated meter towels in brown and blue coming in, even though we look as if they're single insulated, actually double. There's two layers of brown and two layers of blue on those towels. And going out, we've got our neutral and line conductor through our double pole or linked main switch, meaning that when we isolate it, we turn off both live conductors, both line and neutral are isolated in the installation. And as we look where the earthing conductor, in this case, it's a 16 mil earthing conductor compared to the 25 millimeter squared tails. It is connected into the side of the cutout, this being the cutout section here and the cutout fuse, and it means that it is actually connected to the neutral, which is from the supply cable coming in. It separates with the two conductors. This is a concentric cable, one that will be shown in the classroom, one that has an aluminium center line conductor and a combined protective earth neutral, which is copper, which actually looks like almost like an armory of the cable, but you'll see that in the classroom, which comes out and becomes both our neutral and our earthing conductor. So in here is a solid block, which contains both what is the terminations for the neutral and for the earthing conductor. So the earthing arrangement we're looking at here then is one that has a combined neutral and earth. So the earthing arrangement being TN for terra neutral, the earth and neutral are C, combined in the incoming cable and then separated in the installation. So we have a separate neutral and a separate protective conductor entering the installation, making this earthing arrangement TNCS. Other key points of interest in here as well are the sticker here, the green sticker, and I say to my learners, don't go looking just for the green sticker, could have fallen off, but if the green sticker is there and present, it says words like earthing terminal and PME, protective multiple earthing, which is what the supply authorities do to the combined neutral and earth throughout its run, so therefore making this the TNCS earthing arrangement. So that's another good clue to which earthing arrangement we're looking at. We've also got the cutout fuse itself. In this case, it's rated anywhere between 100 and 60 amps. Our one in this installation is rated at 80 amps. But make note of the one in the installation you're looking at, whether it be 60, 80 or 100 amps. Also, as we move through the learning on our course, we'll also see how the earthing arrangement, in this case TNCS, has a maximum external earth fault loop impedance of 0.35 of an ohm.
TNCS earthing arrangement. The terra and neutral, the earth and neutral, are combined within the supply authority's cable and then separate when they get into the installation itself. TNCS, earthing arrangement. This is how it will look in a single phase domestic dwelling. How will it look in images shown to us for our exams? The left hand side of this drawing shows the supply authority's cable. It has a separate line conductor and a combined protective earth neutral conductor. This combined cable is the one we can see coming to the bottom of our cutout. This concentric cable has a copper earth neutral and a aluminium line conductor and will enter the building normally underground but can come in overhead. This drawing also only shows one of the star connected windings on the supply authority's side as well as the centre tap point to earth. The supply authorities will provide the metering equipment and cutout fuse rated either 100, 80 or 60 amps for a single phase domestic dwelling. In a TNCS earthing arrangement, the supply authorities provide one conductor for both protective earth and neutral. This pen conductor on the supply authority side is staked throughout its run. We call this PME, protective multiple earthing. This PME in of the pen conductor is very important, as loss of the neutral on the supply authority's side would mean loss of the protective conductor in the installation. PME helps to prevent this happening. The neutral and earth are separate for the installation. This occurs in the cutout. The pen conductor comes in, a separate neutral and separate earthing conductor come out from the same position. The exam likes to say these are connected together via a solid link. The installation showed on the right-hand side can be a lot shorter in length than that of the supply authority's cable, comprising of a line, neutral and circuit protective conductor. The neutral and earth are only combined on the supply authority's side and not within the installation. The fuse for this circuit will not be 100 amps, considerably less, maybe 20 amps, and housed within the consumer's unit. This drawing shows a TNCS earthing arrangement, and the supply authority's cable now has a maximum external impedance, ZE, of 0.35 of an ohm. Total circuit impedance, ZS, equals ZE plus R1 plus R2. We've identified at the origin of the installation the earthing arrangement is TNCS. We're now going to carry out the external earth fault loop impedance to confirm our external earth fault loop impedance is no greater than the maximum allowed for this installation, which is 0.35 of an ohm. In order to measure the external earth fault loop impedance in this installation, I'm going to need to take off the cover of the distribution board. I have no separate MET where I could disconnect my 16mm earthing conductor, so it must be disconnected from within the consumer unit and where it is terminated in the main earth bar. In order to do this, I'm going to need to isolate the consumer unit at the main switch, the linked main switch or double pole switch. I'm going to need to isolate that, turning off both line and neutral. Before doing so, it would be advisable to turn off individual, in this case, circuit breakers to reduce the amount of load that I would be switching off. It is advisable to tell the customer before turning off the electricity, not just for inconvenience sake, but if they have sensitive electronic equipment that's in, on and being used, it would not be advisable just to turn the power off to those type of equipment. So it's best they power down those items before you turn off the electricity within the distribution board itself. I'll turn off each circuit breaker in turn before I turn off the main switch itself. I can now turn off the main switch and then I can remove the cover. I still need to be careful because the top of the double pole switch will still be live. The rest of the installation will be isolated once the main switch has been turned off. So I'm now going to remove the distribution board cover. Before doing so, I'm just going to move this out of the way and take off the cover. Exposing the conductors underneath. So distribution board cover is off and we can see that even the live parts on the top of the double pole switch is shrouded from contact and the bottom of the double pole switch going through is all been isolated. Therefore, I can disconnect my 16mm earthing conductor in order to perform the test.
With the 16mm earthing conductor removed from the main earth terminal, the parallel earth paths created by things such as gas, water and oil have been removed, giving you a true external earth fault loop impedance of the installation.
In order to carry out this test, I need to set my MFT to the appropriate range. In this case, I need to go into the green section here, which is L for line and protective earth. And I need to move it on this side into the green zone against Z for impedance. We're measuring the external earth fault loop impedance and Z is representing impedance. I've set my instrument on to 2 lead high for this test. I've got the left-hand one on line protective earth and my right-hand one on impedance. So I'm going to carry out the test now to see what reading I get. I'm going to probe onto the least dangerous conductor first, which in this case is the earthing conductor, and then onto the line to do the test. And when I come back off, I'll pull off the line conductor first and then off the earthing conductor second. My probes themselves conform to GS38. With no greater than 4mm exposure tip. This is considerably less than 4. So I'm going to probe onto the earthing conductor first, and then I'm going to probe onto the line conductor. And I've got a reading of 0.25 of an ohm. I'm going to pull off the line conductor, and I'm going to pull off the earthing conductor. There we go. The external earth fault loop impedance has been measured. It's less than the 0.35 ohm of the maximum, being 0.25. Therefore, we've proved the external earth fault loop impedance meets the requirements. With the earthing conductor reconnected and the distribution board cover replaced, we can now turn on the main switch and individual circuit breakers.